Hello again. This video continues to show how JavaScript MVC breaks down the Srchr app into isolated, tested, and documented modules. Part 1 showed how we decided which modules to build. This part, Part 2, shows how we actually build, test, and document them, and then assemble them into the Srchr application. So let's start building stuff. After installing JavaScript MVC, I should see the following folders. Can for CanJS, JavaScript MVC's MVC utilities, DocumentJS for documenting the app, FunkUnit for testing. The JMVC folder contains generators for creating boilerplate code. jQuery PP contains a bunch of useful jQuery extensions, and Steel provides dependency management and production builds. The first thing I did was create an application skeleton with a generator. It created a Srchr folder with index.html, which is the app's homepage, and Srchr.js, which is the entry point for the application. The Srchr folder should contain everything unique to the Srchr application, so I'll put my search, history, and results controllers in there. I use the control generator to create a skeleton for those modules. We put modules that could be shared across applications in a UI folder. Often the folder is a Git submodule that can be shared across several applications. I'll use the control generator again to generate a tabs, placeholder, and list control. Now we have a place to build each module. Let's take a look at how we make these modules. We'll focus on the process, not the code itself. This is because the process matters more than the actual code. Our process shares the same goals as Bitovi. We want to produce quality, tested, and documented apps in the shortest amount of time. Here's a preview of how we do that. First, we create a demo page to experiment with the module's HTML and JavaScript API. Second, we document the module. Next, we write tests for the module, and then write the module's actual code. Finally, we make sure everything passes, and then move on to the next module. Once several modules are complete, we assemble them within higher order modules. To see this process in action, let's start with the tabs module. Looking inside the generated tabs folder, it contains everything we need to develop tabs as a micro application. It not only contains a JavaScript file for the module's code and a less script for the module's styles. It contains a demo page that loads and creates the module, a test script, and a test page that runs the test script. The tabs folder is its own little universe where we can build the tabs module in isolation from the rest of the modules we will build. Now let's walk through the results of our process on the tabs widget. A good API is both powerful, flexible, and easy to use. For this tabs widget, I chose to make it work like a standard tabs widget, with the ability to enable and disable tabs. And by standard tabs widget, I mean the tabs anchor element href property points to the ID of the tab content element to be shown. After adding the HTML for the tabs widget, I set up tabs in a script tag. I use Steel to load the UI tabs module and get the tabs constructor function. The tabs widget needs some way to change which tabs are enabled or disabled. Instead of adding methods to enable or disable tabs, I had tabs accept a can compute of an array of enabled tabs IDs. By changing the enabled IDs, tabs will enable and disable tab buttons. I demo this functionality by adding a button that, when clicked, changes the IDs in enabled. Now that we have a rough picture of the tab module's API, we will fill out the picture more with documentation. Documentation makes you think about how your code is going to be used. If you can easily document a module's functionality, it's a good bet that you're designing a useful API. In tabs.js, I documented how to create a new tabs widget within a multi-line comment. Later, we'll use document.js to generate a documentation page from this comment. I also added the tabs demo page to the documentation so people will be able to see the tabs widget in action. Once I settled on a good API with a demo and documentation, I moved on to writing tests. Creating tests, like a demo page and documentation, helps you explore and improve the API of the module you're writing. But it also adds a critical additional benefit. It can verify the API is actually working. In tabs test.js, I added tests for showing and hiding tabs, enabling and disabling tabs, and more. Once that was complete, I started writing the tabs code. At this point, with a full picture of the API, a demo page, and tests, it's quite easy to write the tabs module. In tabs.js, I implemented tabs with can control. While writing the tabs code, I use its test and demo page to make sure the module is working. Once all tests passed, I moved on to the next module. I repeated the previous 5 steps with the list module. I created a demo page that uses the list module. I documented the list module, wrote tests for the list module, wrote the list module's code, and finally, I verified the tests and demo worked. Once these lower-level views were complete, I began assembling them into controllers. I combined tabs and list into the results controller, following the same process as before, starting with the results demo page. The results controller is created on a simple div element. It's passed the observable from the first video that represents the current search. Next, I added documentation and tested the results controller, which is mostly testing the integration between the tabs and list views. The results code is pretty straightforward. It needs to set up tabs to show and hide a list view for each service. It starts by translating current search into the enabled and params computes that tabs and the lists need. Next, results renders a template that creates the HTML the tab needs and creates a list view for each model type. It creates the list view with the list for helper. Finally, the tabs view is created. After verifying the results controller's test and demo page works, I repeated this process for the search and history controllers. Now I will show you how I assembled the controllers into the main application. Of course, I will follow the same process as I've used for everything else. But this time, instead of a demo page, I'll set up the page users are actually going to visit. In Srchr.html, I added the elements we will create the search, history, and results controllers on. I added Srchr's documentation in Srchr.md. An application's documentation typically covers how to install, run, test, and build the app, and generate the app's documentation. The application's test script loads and runs every module's tests and then provides some tests of its own. Its own tests test the integration between the various controllers. The code for Srchr is very simple. It simply loads the controllers it needs, creates the shared observable current search, and creates each controller. Now I can actually use the app. And verify the app works by running every module's tests. All the tests passed. Amazing. Right now, Steel is loading the unminified version of every JavaScript, less, CSS, and template file. To make Srchr load faster, I'll combine and minify all the app's files into a single JavaScript and CSS file using the app's build script. To make Steel use the production files, I'll load the production version of Steel in index.html. To generate the documentation, I run the app's docs script. This creates docs.html. If we check out Tab's documentation page, we can see the working demo as well as a link to its test page. And we're done. Let's look at the result of what we've accomplished. The result is that every module has its own documentation with a working demo, and every module is tested. We have low-level view widgets that could almost certainly be reused in other projects. The complexity of assembling the low-level widgets is broken up by using the observer pattern. Everything is isolated. And Steel's build, not to mention can control and can view, make our application load fast. This is how you build an application, regardless of what library or framework you use. However, JavaScript MVC makes it super easy, so use it.